वेलकम बैक फ्रेंड्स, वी आर लर्निंग किंगडम प्रोटिस्टा एंड इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट प्रोटोजोअन्स। वी हैव लर्न अबाउट क्राइसोफाइट्स, डायनोफ्लैजेलेट्स, यूग्लेनॉइड्स, स्लाइम मोल्ड्स एंड दीज आर द लास्ट इन दिस लिस्ट विच आर प्रोटोजोअन्स। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। एज द नेम सजेस्ट, प्रोटो मीन्स प्रिमिटिव, ओके, and zoons means animals. So these are the primitive relatives of animals. We study protozoans before the first phylum of kingdom Animalia, which is Porifera. So before Porifera we study protozoans because these are the primitive relatives of animals. These are heterotrophic and live as predators or parasitic, okay. Mainly these are heterotrophics, either they will predators or parasitic. In parasitic they can be ectoparasite or endoparasite. Ecto means they will live on the surface of the host, and endo means they will live inside the cell or inside the body of the host. So they can be parasitic and cause disease, okay. After we have learned that they are the primitive relatives of animals in the name, they can be divided into these four groups: amoeboid protozoans, flagellated protozoans, ciliated protozoans and sporozoans. So let's learn about amoeboid protozoans. These can be aquatic, these are aquatic actually, maybe marine or freshwater. They can live in marine as well as freshwater or in moist soil also. They possess pseudopodia. What does it mean by pseudopodia? Pseudo means false and podia means feet. So they will have false feet, and by using this pseudopodia, like they can engulf food material inside their cell. So let's say this is they will have amoeba like structure, and in this, suppose this is the food material and they want to engulf that material, so they will spread their pseudo feeds and engulf that food material inside the cell like this, okay, and they will feed upon that food. So in this way they will use their pseudo feeds for their to intake their food material. So that's why they possess pseudopodia, and the example is entamoeba, okay. So these are amoeboid protozoans. Then second group is flagellated protozoans. What does it mean by flagellated? Means they will contain flagella. We all know that what is flagella is a hair like structure, which by using that flagella they can move from one place to other place. They are free living, that's why. And parasitic, example is trypanosoma. Trypanosoma are parasitic organism and cause like sleeping sickness like diseases. Then third category is ciliated protozoans. They have cilia on the surface of them, their cell, like this. In this figure you can see the paramecium have cilia, like short hair like structures on their surface. By using that cilia they can attach or move or crawling, for crawling movement they can use this cilia. They also possess a gullet or cavity. By using that gullet, which opens outside the cell surface, and by using that cavity they can engulf food material. So these are ciliated protozoans, and example is paramecium, which is shown in the figure. Then last one is sporozoans, which are the organism have infectious spore like stage in their life cycle. They will have infectious spore like stage in their life cycle. The best example is Plasmodium, which is malarial parasite which cause disease like malaria in the human beings. So and there can be the variety of species like Plasmodium vivax, Plasmodium falciparum, etc. So this is all about protozoans. I hope this is clear to you. If you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe to our channel and share this video to your friends. Thank you so much.